We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman, Three Jokers, Book 1. This is under DC's Black Label from 2020, even though it's several years late. Written by Geoff Johns, illustrated by Jason Fabok. Brad Anderson was the colorist, Rob Leigh, letterer. Cover illustrated and colored by Jason Fabok and Brad Anderson. I have the variant cover with Batman. I actually like this one better. It's a little more subtle. The other one I thought was a little over the top with the Joker. Now, Batman makes it back to the Batcave injured, and he's getting stitched up, and we get to see a lot of his scars and how he got them in little bursts of panels, which is actually pretty interesting. And then we of course have an obligatory flashback to his parents' death, and we learn that the Joker is rampaging across Gotham, and it seems like he is in three places at once. Barbara gets word, and so does the Red Hood, and they all go looking for the Joker. Now there are three people that appear to be victims of the Joker wearing the old Red Hood outfit, and Gordon is at the scene with his men. That's where Batman shows up first, and Batgirl is there as well, and that's when they discover something that the cops didn't notice right away, is that there is a bunch of chemicals missing. Now, they get some information on where to go, and things go really, really crazy. We get to see all three Jokers in one location. Now, the police aren't real sure if two of them are imposters, but we did learn a while back, I think it was in Endgame, that there are, in fact, three Jokers. Whether they've been coordinating this whole time or not isn't clear, or if this is the first time they've all teamed up. Nonetheless, we get to see a pretty nasty battle and the return of Gaggy, Joker's old sidekick, who was like a court jester type. And there is a really dark twist ending. I can't say much more about it, but it's an ending I didn't think they were gonna do, but they totally did it, and it made the whole book worth reading. This was a really well done book. It's much more mature. There is definitely a little bit more gore than you're normally gonna find in a Batman book, but this is Black Label, which means intended for mature readers. This is in prestige format, so it is perfect bound, and it is $7. I didn't have a problem paying for it once I read it. I thought it was a bit steep at first, but the art is fantastic, the story is really solid, and that ending was crazy. So I'm gonna give this a really high recommendation. This should be in every serious Batman collector's collection so far, and it's probably one of the best Batman stories I've read this year. I know a lot of people didn't like it, but I don't understand why. I thought it was a really good story, and the twist ending really threw me for a loop. I'm absolutely looking forward to book two, which hopefully will come out sooner rather than later. I'm getting tired of DC's delay nonsense. I'm still waiting on the next issue of Batman vs. Ra's al Ghul from Neil Adams. There's two issues left, guys. Where is it? Hopefully they don't pull that with this one. So high recommendation on this one. Definitely worth checking out. That's gonna do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description of my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Batman, Three Jokers from DC Comics in 2020. This is part of their Black Label imprint, and this is the second part of the three-part miniseries. I bought the variant cover with Batgirl because I like that cover better. This is written by Geoff Johns. Jason Fabok was the illustrator, Brad Anderson color artist, Rob Leigh letterer. Cover illustrated and colored by Jason Fabok and Brad Anderson. Mark Doyle and Amito Totoro were the editors. Now this issue starts out with one of the Jokers having an episode of sorts, and Batman and Batgirl responding to the death of a judge. There are ties in there that link it to Joe Chill, so Batman's got to deal with that, but Red Hood is on the loose, and they're trying to find him as well. Red Hood ends up getting himself captured, and the two of the Jokers are interrogating him and torturing him, effectively. Batman and Batgirl try to save him, but they are attacked by a bunch of Jokerized people. Things get a little bad for the group, and we learn some devastating realities. There's a lot that happens here. I'm not sure how they're going to wrap it up in a three-issue arc. The problems I'm having with this book is they're not telling us anything about the three Jokers. Why are there three of them? Their origins? Which one came first? Which one was the real one? If there is something along those lines. I don't think they can wrap that up in three issues. This is really well written. I do really enjoy this book, but there's a lot of questions that are unanswered here. What Jason did at the end of book one, how is that going to have ramifications on the continuity continuity and what happens between the dynamics of the characters. It's mildly addressed here, but it's really glossed over. So I think there's a lot of questions that are not going to be able to be answered in this miniseries, and that's going to frustrate me, but it's really well done for what it is. The art is beautiful in the book. I think Fabok is an amazing artist. The colors are outstanding. Everything about this is really well done. I like that it's perfectly bound. I didn't have a problem paying $7 for it, but I think the ending's going to be unsatisfying, which just makes me think this is just another ploy to get me to read another miniseries later down the line. Which, if they wrap this one up good enough, yeah, I would definitely do that, but I'm a little worried about how they're going to wrap it up. Until I read that issue, I am going to recommend this book. I thought it was really, really good. So we'll see how it ends when the third issue comes out, but I am a little hesitant about that. That'll do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.
We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman 3 Jokers Issue 3, written by Geoff Johns, illustrated by Jason Fabok, colors by Brad Anderson, letters by Rob Leigh, cover illustrated and colored by Jason Fabok and Brad Anderson, edited by Mark Doyle and Amito Totoro. I have the Red Hood cover, I like it, it's pretty good. Relates kinda to what's going on, but for a profile piece, it's pretty solid. We learned quite a bit in here. Batman and Red Hood kinda have a bit of a throwdown because Red Hood is calling Bruce a coward, but their confrontation with the Joker has to take priority, and that means they have to figure out what his plan is. Now, there are two Jokers left, the comedian and the criminal, but a lead lies in Joe Chill's cell, because Joe Chill is being held hostage by the Jokers. And we get some interesting background that I don't want to give away about Joe Chill, and then we have our final showdown, which was a lot more interesting than I thought it was going to be. I can't really say too much without giving away the end, but some things happened I didn't expect, and it definitely took an interesting twist, especially the end. Now, as a standalone storyline, this is fine, but I don't know how they're going to work this into continuity if they're even going to bother acknowledging it. I think they're going to peripherally touch on it, and then it'll barely ever be spoken of. So yeah, it was an interesting story, but I think it ends up not being fully satisfying because there's a lot of loose ends, especially with what Red Hood did at the end of issue 1. That is kind of ignored and very much skirted. It is mentioned, but it's really never addressed. And the end twist was pretty interesting. My problem with it is that they have to get away from this idea that Batman and Joker are symbiotic. I think it's tiresome. Plus, the scene at the Monarch in here really kind of goes against what happened in Joker War. So I'm guessing this is sort of a Elseworlds semi-continuity book. To some degree, what happened in Joker War contradicts what happened here. Especially at the Monarch. There's some interesting continuity issues that arise from this, but overall it was an enjoyable read. It just felt unfinished in some respects. But I liked it, and I thought it was really well drawn. It really should have come out years ago, and it would have had a lot more impact. But I'll recommend it if you're looking for kind of a Joker story that isn't written by some garbage hack writer that they usually get, like Tom King or Mariko Tamaki, because I'm not interested in any of that trash. So from that perspective, yeah, this was pretty fun, but it just didn't really give me a sense of a complete story. If they did a sequel to this, I'd be interested. I would have liked this to have been a longer story, I guess. So I'm not sure how I feel about it. I will recommend it because I thought it was very well written and very well illustrated. It just felt incomplete. So I don't know if they're planning a sequel to this or not. Kind of hope they are. I hope Geoff Johns does more work at DC, but I don't have a lot of faith in the way things are going that that's going to happen. That'll do it for this one. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Streamlabs, and Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.